Well, hello and welcome to today's lecture. We're going to continue set theory. Let's review a little bit. Recall. Suppose we have some sets. We can consider them as tables in SQL, structured query language. And form some new sets, new objects. Let A and B be two sets. Remember that when we are doing the operations between sets, especially when we are forming, constructing the complement of a set, we need a larger set, which we call the universal set. Let U be the universal set. So we can assume that we have the larger set or the universal set here. We have many sets inside the universal set. A, B, C, some might have intersection, D, and so. We can form the union between two sets, which is defined as the set of all x values such that x belongs to the first set or belongs to the second set. We can define a new operator between them. A intersection with B, which is the set of all x values, all elements, such that those elements are in the first set and in the second set. All the common elements between them, the elements that are repeated between two sets. We can define the complement of a set by using a complement, a prime, or a bar, which is defined to be all values that belong to the universal set, but they are not in the set A itself. All x values such that x is not a member of A. The members in the complement of set A. Then we define the difference between two sets, A minus B, which is equal to the all members such that those members are in the first set, but not in the second set. So x is in A and x is not in the second set. So how we define the sets, these are the basic definitions. Also recall that we say two sets are equal, A is equal to B if and only if they are subsets of each other. A is a subset of B, and at the same time, B is a subset of A. So we're going to use this definition to actually show that the sets are equal to each other. Some important set identities that we're going to list them here. Remember that in logic, in chapter 1 and chapter 2, we talked about identities or laws or rules that we use in logic to be able to prove equivalent statements. So the same for sets. Set identities. Perfect. The first one is commutative laws. Commutative laws. computative loss. These losses, if you have two sets or more sets, and if you form the union between A, B, it is nothing but the union of B, A. So we can switch the position of A and B. Still we have equality. What's the meaning of that? It means that A union B is a subset of B union A, and at the same time, B union A is the subset of A union. So that's the meaning of it. We have union, of course we have commutative law for intersection as well. What's the meaning of that? It means that A intersection B can be written as B intersection B. A intersection B is a subset of B intersection A and vice versa. The second one, the second one is associative. These losses, suppose you have three sets, A, B, C. Remember that you can always generalize the idea to more sets. A union B union C can be written as A union with B union C. So if we take the union between A and B, we form a new set. And then take the union of that set with a third set like C, it is equivalent to, it's the same as finding the union between B and C first, form this new set, then take the union with A. You get the exact same final set. How about intersection? Of course, we have this for intersection as well. A intersection B intersection C is the same as A intersection with B intersection C. This is important. Distributive law. Distributive loss. It says you can distribute union over intersection and also distribute intersection over union. A union B intersection C. A union parentheses B intersection C can be written in expanded form of A union B. A union B intersection A union C. Remember that, for example, in algebra, we learned that A parentheses B plus C can be written as AB plus AC. We distribute A over parentheses. We have the same logic here. We are distributing A over B intersections, just distribution. What if you have A intersection B union C? You can distribute A over parentheses. You get A intersection B union A intersection C. This is called distributive. Remember that. If you have the expanded form on the left-hand side, you can write it in compact form as well. So from left to right, distributing from right to left, writing in compact. Next slide is called identity. So identity law says A union with empty set is equal to A, and A intersection with the universal set is equal to A as well. Number five, the complement laws. This law says A union with its complement is always equal to the universal set. And if I take the intersection between A and its complement, it is always equal to empty set. A and its complement, they're always disjoint. Six, double complements. Remember that we had double negations. Here we have double complements. If you have a set, you take its complement, then again, you take the complement of the complement. This is equivalent to saying that, hey, I have set A. We call double negation. Double negation says, hey, if you have the negation of negation on the statement, this is equivalent to the statement as well. So double negation and double complement. This is perfect. Let's move on to more identities. I'm going to erase the board. I need more space. Number seven, idempotent laws. So, idempotent law says if you take the union of a set with itself, it must be equal to that set. And also, if you take the intersection of a set by itself, it must be equal to A itself. Number eight. Universal. Bounds. Laws. Universal bound laws says if you take the union between any set and the universal set, it is equal to the universal set. And also, if I take the intersection between A and empty set, it must be equals to empty set and not A. A intersection with empty set, the set that has nothing in it, is equal to the empty set. 9, De Moorman's laws. Well, remember that in logic, we say that if they have the negation of P and Q, it's the negation of P or the negation of Q. So take a look at this. Here you have A intersection B, complement. Complement in set theory and negation in logic. Not P and Q. In logic, it was not P or not Q. It's not the case that P and Q, which is equivalent saying that, it's not the case that P or, because you have to distribute this negation over the parentheses, and it's not the case, Q. So here, if we think about it this way, that you are having the negation, it's going to be equivalent saying that we have the negation of P or the complement of the first set. The complement of intersection is union, so let me use a different color. Union with the complement of the second set. Also remember that to distribute negation over or, which was not P and not Q. So if we have the complement of A union B, it is equivalent to the complement of A and the complement of De Moorman's laws. We saw them in logic, and here you're using them in set theory. Absorption laws. Number 10. Absorption law says if you have a union with a intersection with any other set, this is equivalent to A. Also, if you have the intersection, A intersection, A union B, this is equivalent to A. So these two laws are absorption laws. If you have, for example, combination of sets that is written this way, A union with another set, that set is A, the same set intersection with another set. It's equivalent to having just A. So we can simplify some complicated or complex combination of sets. You see here. A intersection with set A union with another set. It's equivalent to A. If you have a complicated complex form of a combination of sets, you can simplify that and write it as just A. Complements of the universal set and the empty set. The complement of the universal set is equal to empty set, and the complement of empty set is equal to the universal set. And finally, set difference. If you have A minus B, this can be written as A intersection with B complement. This is also another important law that we use in proof to show equality or any other relation between sets. So let's take a look at some theorems and actually use these laws to help us prove relation between sets. This theorem says for all sets A, B, and C, prove the following. Show that we can distribute union over intersection, and it is actually equal to the intersection between the unions. So this is our goal. How do we prove equality between two sets? Recall that. To show that two sets are equal to each other, we need to show that X is a subset of Y and Y is a subset of X. We need to prove this if and only if Y. So suppose this is your X, and suppose this is your Y. So we want to show that X is a subset of Y and Y is a subset of X. But how do we show that two sets are subsets of each other? Set X is a subset of set Y. So to show that X is a subset of Y, you need to show that for any random element in X, that random element belongs to the second set or Y. This is our goal. Show that X is a subset of Y. Let us take a random element. Element like X belongs to X. Remember that your X is A union with B intersection C. Okay, what's now? X belongs to the union. You're right, by using the definition of union, definition of union, it means that X belongs to A, X belongs to A, or X belongs to B intersection C. Remember that we want to show that that small element, that member belongs to one or A union B and A union C. And note that we are getting back to logic using and or. So far we have X belongs to A or X belongs to another set B intersection C. Again, by using the definition of intersection, intersection. X belongs to B and X belongs to C. So this is what we have so far. X is in A or X is in B and X is in C. Just following the definition of the union and intersection. Okay, so let us take a look at this. Your X belongs to A. We have to analyze each of these separately. X belongs to A. It means that X belongs to A union with any other set. A union with any other set. That other set can be B. And at the same time, when X belongs to A, X belongs to A union with any other set. That can be C. And X belongs to A union with C. Okay. X belongs to A union B, and which translates into intersection A union with C. So X belongs to A union B, intersection A union C. We're done. So we're done with this case that if X belongs to A, X belongs to A, we can conclude that X belongs to A union B, intersection A union C. Now we're going to move on to the second case. X belongs to the intersection. So now, what if X belongs to B and X belongs to C? So let's call it case one. Case one that we already built. Now, case two. The second case says, by using the definition of the intersection, X belongs to B and X belongs to C. The same argument. When X belongs to B, you can conclude that X belongs to B union with any other set, like A. When X belongs to C, it means that X belongs to set C union with any other set. C union with any other set, that set can be A. We don't care. And the connector in between is AND. Take a look at your AND. We're using AND as the connector between these two. X belongs to B, so X belongs to B union A, and X belongs to C. X belongs to C union A. What's the meaning of that? It means that X belongs to B union A, and at the same time, intersection C union A. But commutative law says you can just write this as A union B. Can write this as A union C. A union B, intersection A union C. And we're done. So if X belongs to the first set or belongs to the second set, we show that the first set is a subset of the second set. So either cases, we've proved that set X is a subset of set Y. We're done with this part. Now we're going to move on to the second part. We need to show that Y is also a subset of X. Okay, perfect. We proved that left-hand side is a subset of right-hand side. Now we need to show that right-hand side is also subset of left-hand side. So show that. So to show that Y is a subset of X, we need to take a random element in Y and that show that that random element belongs to X. So let's take a random element like X belongs to Y, and we show that X belongs to X as well. This is our goal. Okay. X belongs to Y. Small element, Y is A, union B, and intersection A, union C. By using the definition of intersection, we have the following. Definition of intersection, we have X belongs to A union B and X belongs to A union C. Okay. Note that we want to show that X belongs to A or X belongs to B intersection C. Take a look at this case. Let's work with this case first. Case one. And note that since it has and, you have to consider case one and case two combined together. Case two. Take a look at this. So I'm going to write case one and case two next to each other because you have and, it's not or that you can separate them from each other. So case one and case two. Case one says X belongs to A union B. X belongs to A union B. By definition of union, X belongs to A or X belongs to B. X belongs to A or X belongs to B. And here, again, we're combining these two cases together because we have and X belongs to A unions. So, take a look at this case. If X is in A, you're done. You don't have anything to prove. So if I'm going to write this one down here for you. If X is in A, we don't have anything to prove. The same for that case there. Just writing this here. If X belongs to A, it is done. Since X can be in A union with any other set, any other set. So that set can be linear section C. That's it. Now, what if X is not in A? X is not in A, it means that X still wants to be. X belongs to B, so X is not in A, X belongs to B, you're sure about that. If X is in A, you're done, you don't have anything to prove. But if X is not in A, X belongs to B, X belongs to B, and here you have the definition, X belongs to A, or X belongs to C. But you know that X is not in A. X is not in A, so you have X is in B and X is in C. So X belongs to B, intersection C. So X belongs to B, intersection C. It means that X belongs to B intersection C, union with any other set. B intersection C, union with any other set. We show that a random element in Y is now in X. So Y is the subset of X. Tell us though, you're going to prove one of them. So this theorem, we're going to prove one of the De Moivre's laws. I want to prove that the complement of the union of two sets is equal to the intersection of their complements. A complement, intersection, a complement. Okay. We want to show that two sets are equal to each other. Suppose the first one is X, the second one is Y. Set X, set Y. To show that X is equal to Y, we need to show two things. We need to show that X is a subset of Y, and at the same time, Y is a subset of X. So let's put question marks. Let's focus on the first one. Show that X is a subset of Y. Show that X is a subset of Y. You take a random element in X and we show that that random element lands in the second set. You take X belongs to X and we show that belongs to Y. Okay, we put a question mark because you're trying to prove this second part. Okay, X belongs to X. X belongs to A union B complement. What was the definition of complement? Recall. A union B complement. It means that you have the set of all elements like X such that X is not in A union. Okay. Or you might say that it's not the case that, let's write it in logic form, it is not the case that X is in A or B. Okay, perfect. It's not the case that. What's the meaning of it's not the case that? It's equivalent to negation. The negation. It's not the case that. X belongs to A. Or X belongs to B. The negation of X belongs to A or X belongs to B. What's the negation? The negation of X belongs to A or X belongs to B. We're converting our SIP into logical statement. So the negation of X belongs to A or X belongs to B is equivalent to the negation of X in A and the negation X in B. Well, X is not in A and X is not in B. So A intersection B, both of them are complements. This is your okay. So X is a subset of Y. Let's just put a smiley face here. We just proved that if I take a random element in X, that random element belongs to Y. Well, now we're going to prove that if we take a random element in the second set, that random element actually lands in the first set. So to show that Y is a subset of X, we need to take a random element in the second set and show that that element is in the first set, the question mark. Perfect. So we're taking a random element like X belongs to A complement intersection B complement. What's the meaning of that? By using the definition of intersection, using the definition of intersection, what do we have? We have X belongs to A complement and X belongs to B complement. So A complement, it means that it's not the case that X is in A. X belongs to B complement. It's not the case that X is in B. It is not the case that X belongs to A and it is not the case that X belongs to B. Now we are connecting these two using AND. So what do we have here? We have the negation of X is in A, the negation X is in B, and you're connecting them together using AND. So it's not the case that X is in A and it's not the case that X is in B. The negation of P and the negation of Q, it means that it's not the case that X is in A or X is in, it's not the case that X is in A or X is in B. It means that X is in A or X is in B complement. So which is equivalent to A intersection, A union B complement, which is our X. So we just showed that if I take any random element in Y, that random element is in X. So we just show the second one. So it means that these two sets are equal to each other.